560 days after closing off our country from the world, the Prime Minister has announced plans to resume international travel next month. Qantas will take off from Sydney on November the 14th, and for vaccinated Australians coming home, hotel quarantine is all but a thing of the past.
Bags packed and ready to go, soon you could be too.
It's time to give Australians their lives back.
The Prime Minister quarantining at the lodge, unveiling his latest plan to allow Australians to fly out and more to fly home.
It's been really tough.
Nathan Booth hasn't seen his parents in Brisbane for 3 years. He's been told his father does not have long to live.
I would definitely like to see my parents again. It would mean a lot.
And a homecoming might not be too far away.
And Australia will be ready for takeoff very soon.
Under the plan, once 80% of a state's population is vaccinated, Australians from there who have been double-dosed could leave the country. There won't be travel bubbles or traffic light systems, and for those returning, the double jab could allow quarantine at home or even an Airbnb for 7 days rather than in a hotel for 14. That's if states come on board.
And we're going to be open. Not just for business, we're going to be open to the world.
Sydney appears set to do that first. New South Wales leading the race to 80%. Victoria's past 50%, so too South Australia. Queensland and Western Australia are back in the field and setting more conditions on resuming international travel.
We need to make sure we get the people vaccinated and the hospitals prepared.
The question is, well, how can you go to Bali or Fiji, but you can't go to Queensland?
Airlines are opening the hangars, the Flying Kangaroo, set for departure on November 14 to London and Los Angeles. The tourism industry, largely grounded, will have to wait a little longer. The focus on arrivals will be returning Australians and permanent residents.
The industry has been losing over $3.5 billion a month.
The prospect of opening up international travel has some predicting ticket prices will fall.
The specials will come through in January, February next year, when there are a lot more planes, a lot more seats in the air.
While the Prime Minister announces an overhaul to home quarantine while in quarantine, it's the existing arrangements he's indicating could prevent him attending the G20 in Rome and a major international climate summit in Glasgow next month.
My first and most important group that I need to talk to about our plan is not overseas, it's right here in Australia.
As is an election due next year. Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.